size a brain like this, I'm sure other control systems were possible. Okay, the whole artificial intelligence vehicle is going down, no? Think about an aeroplane. The aeroplane was inspired by looking at birds, but people who tried to copy birds by attaching wings didn't go very well, no? Yes? Is there anything, physics people tell me, is there anything similar to the structural engineering of how an aeroplane flies versus a bird? Eventually you have lift. Okay, that and that, eventually. But except for lift, is there any parallel? I'll challenge you, tell me.
Bone shaped belly, that's
okay, that's so protein features, right? Okay. So there is no why. Why does a bird do this? Evolution. There's only that. Okay, if our atmosphere was a hell of a lot thicker, we may not have had birds. I don't know. Yeah. Why did an organism grow a certain size? Okay, after a point, your bones can't hold you up. Okay, why do we have an internal endoskeleton versus an exoskeleton? How many of you have memorized insects have an exoskeleton? Yeah. How many of you have memorized this? Imagine if an elephant were to have a steel-like external casing. Wouldn't be able to hold it up, no? So these are all engineering principles. They came because we have gravity. I don't know if you could have known how to do the science. So you could see biology in this light, right?
Or bring some good experiments, some very fascinating. You do good experiments so often. And then you start enjoying. While you do that, gradually you should come to the stage when you start enjoying what you're doing. And unless you come to that stage, see, the best example is in music. Any of you have a neighbor who started learning violin?
Yes,
it's a horrible experience. Because if your neighbors start with it, it's so horrible. Noise that it makes. So you will never, but. From that, because the same thing, you will not enjoy something to start with. Gradually, as you start, you go deeper and deeper and deeper to start. You enjoy, and if you can enjoy well, then you can impact others. See, the success of Amitabh Bachchan is that when he is doing he himself is enjoying. That is what is being communicated to the whole community. Unless you enjoy, even Virat Kohli is not thinking of 1.2, but the, how much time is $15 million is his worth or something like that. But it is not that. He plays that ball only for that ball, nothing else. Not keeping an eye on the score. If I am getting a ball, I am just concentrated on that ball, nothing else.
Very surprisingly, it turns out at the heart of all these kind of arguments is a notion of information and information processing, which Gibbs was aware of, but which he did not say in those words. The words information and information processing actually came much later, you know, in the hands of Claude Shannon in the 1940s, 1950s, where he wrote down something called entropy, which was something, you know, which had already been called entropy in statistical mechanics by Gibbs. And somehow for a while people were not clear on whether these are the same object or not. But over time it has become clear that information processing is at the heart of many of the arguments of statistical mechanics. So statistical mechanics, really, one can say all the probability theory and statistics that goes into it is really ideas of information processing. And then there is Newton's laws of mechanics. And in fact, to get many of the results of statistical mechanics, you don't need Newton's laws of mechanics. You can just throw it out. You can just put in a much more general rule for dynamics and apply the rules of statistics, and you get out the same law. So that is sort of the magic of statistical mechanics. Then kind of do these things correctly.
Luckily, and I think in many cases luck plays a role on what choices you make. I decided to work on a research project, which was an opportunity came up in second year, and that basically completely changed or like set me on the path towards a research career. I noticed that I was working extremely hard. I mean, typically I was a lazy student. I did not like to work, burn the midnight oil, as I said. I liked my sleep a lot. So I found that I was burning the midnight oil and not complaining about it. And I was just obsessed with this thing. And there was a realization that, oh my god, I really seem to like this kind of stuff. So maybe, and this is research, maybe this is what I want. Quantum computing had not even entered at that stage. I am sort of an amateur musician. I thought I wanted to do physics of music. Because I heard a talk by a senior who talked about physics of tablas. I don't know how many of you have studied about that. You can get into vessel functions, vibrational modes of the tabla are very unique, and this little black stuff they put in the middle actually plays an interesting role, and I was just amazed, oh my god, you can derive all of this from mathematics, and I like this. So in Cambridge, I did a project on studying the modes of vibration of the guitar mode. I actually took apart my guitar and doing experiments on it. Getting it with a small hammer and measuring the impulse of both the force and then detecting somewhere else in the body what the response of that.
Try to take all the matter in the stump and squeeze it up as gravity wants to do, then these electrons start coming and sitting very near to each other. Now, and electrons are not allowed to occupy exactly the same state. Now, there's two elements to the degrees of freedom of classical or quantum particles. Okay, let's say classical. Classically, there are two elements to the degrees of freedom of a particle, its position and its momentum. If you squeeze the electrons so that they come very near to each other, so two or many electrons are going to have almost exactly the same position, then they better have pretty different momenta, otherwise they would start violating Pauli's exclusion principle. But if these electrons now start having larger and larger momenta, that means this collection of electrons has higher and higher energy, because momentum costs energy. And so if you put what I just said into mathematics, you find a formula for the energy of this cloud of electrons as a function of how small you make the cloud. And as you make the cloud smaller and smaller and smaller, the energy becomes larger and larger and larger, because the electrons have to explore higher and higher momentum.
By the fact that there were physicists, biologists, doctors, chemists, and all of them were trying to solve this problem. And we could see fascinating results. We could see results in real patients getting treated by these diagnostics. And so I felt that, you know, this is a field that is not only using the fundamentals of so many things, it's also being able to change lives. And that is, I think, what really at that point of time, that is something that really inspired me to come into this field, because I felt that even if we are doing something on a fundamental level, eventually it might lead to something that might help individuals. So essentially, you know, there were people who were talking about their molecules that had gone into patients, that had been used to remove tumor, and we could see doctors showing videos of their surgeries and people actually recovering because of these things, and I found that extremely fascinating.
This welding of quarter-inch pipes, orbital welding, was one company in India which could do it. Okay. What did they do? Nahi saab, hamara bahut experience hai. Kahan pe kaam kiya? Nahi, Dubai mein kaam kiya. Nahi, nahi, wo automobile industry hai na, hum log kilometer ka pipe nikal. Okay. Okay. It's very good. Na zyada nahi, lekin purity. Haan saab, hum log karke denge na, so I said, okay, please weld this pipe. They were very pissed off with me because for 1 week, they used to weld pipes, they used to cut the weld, and I said, I'm not happy with this. Okay, because the weld has to be perfect. Out here, you know how they cut a pipe with a saw? I saw him cut a pipe. Then, when he cut a pipe, it's got some roughness at the edge, some particles. So they'll take a sandpaper and they'll rub it, that makes the particles fall. And how do you clean it? Put it in your mouth and do I'm like, holy shit, man. I'm worried about, you know, parts per million water vapor. If you're gonna put that pipe in your mouth, you might as well throw that pipe away. Okay. So now we taught those guys how to weld. At least today there are 20 such people in India who can weld. We can build these systems today.
World for a few years before I came to finance. I was in Watsi firm for 2 years. I was in management consulting firm for a year. There you have lots of things that need to be done. So the issue is you saw something quickly and move on to something else. And in the world that I'm in right now, you know, a student comes up and solving something, they say, go back, spend 2 more months, you need to think more deeply and come up with you know, really understand what you want. So if you enjoy thinking things deeply, going to the root causes, then something like a PhD makes sense.
See, what is more important to me, averages or fluctuations? So it turns out there is a nice story. Story called My Watch. Good. So you all have read this? Anyway, so this My Watch, so I mean, it's a nice story. This fellow is given a watch and is very proud of the watch and he works very well and he loves the watch and his whole life is centered around the watch. But one day the watch begins to go wrong. The watch is acting very strange. Sometimes it is 3 hours forward, sometimes it is half an hour backward. So it's very difficult to tell the time. But every 24 hours it gives you the exact time. It has a very good average. So this is what you said. Knowing the average is a mild virtue in a watch. Okay. So fluctuations are sometimes much more important than the average. This is what I want. So I told you about the watch.
And then he came back and he punched that number. Because he had taken the system back so he can control it. And he started saying the system back was starting to diverge. The solution that he had drawn before, the new curve, would not support a good solution. If you were a normal human being, what would you do? I mean, heart karakar or bolo karakar?
Yeah, it's not working.
Huh?
Probably the machine is not working.
Or, even more, मैंने गलती कर ली ताकि ह्यूमन एरर इज द बेस्ट बट नो ही वाज अ फिजिसिस्ट ही सेड आई कांट मेक अ मिस्टेक मैं जेम बॉल आई डोंट मेक मिस्टेक्स आई ईट बेक मिस्टेक्स फॉर ब्रेकफास्ट एंड स्पिट देम आउट फॉर डिनर आई डोंट मेक ही सेड नीदर द इक्विपमेंट इज रॉन्ग देयर सम न्यू थिंग्स And we were like, you know, hey Ram, what a cute guy. You know, he was telling us all this story. He was student, we were your age. And I was working in chaos. I had already fallen in love with the subject. So I said, my God. And then, total sanhana. You know, so what do you think is the moral of the story? And being like a good Indian, never give up, persistence, this, that. He said, nonsense. For every good research, coffee. Ha ha ha.